This is a review of the Onewind new bridge hammock. And the first thing that you'll notice is that it only has one spreader pole. It's a little bit heavier material, and it's also a little bit wider. This, for comparison, these are the Eagle's Nest Outfitters, the Eno Skylight spreader poles. And I haven't weighed them precisely, but in my hand, the one heavier pole from the Onewind, to me, weighs basically the same as those two super light spreader poles in the Eno version. So now I'm going to hook this up to the Eno Helios straps, suspension straps, and then we'll also compare that to the Onewind straps, suspension tree straps. So this is the Onewind bridge hammock, and the first thing that you notice is that it's long. I had the Eno Skylight hammock attached to that tree. For the Onewind hammock, I moved to another tree that's a good 8 feet farther away. Of course, the suspension is fully adjustable, but I'm using the same exact suspension just as an even comparison. The Onewind hammock does not use toggles. Instead, it uses a carabiner. So there's a loop from the suspension on the hammock. You've got a gathered end at the foot. And then you've got two lines at the head end, again coming up to a carabiner. And then the head end has the spreader, so we'll attach that next. So this is the single spreader pole that goes on the Onewind bridge hammock. There are no tabs. There's nothing to attach it to except the actual half hitch, the actual loop that's on the suspension. So all you do, and there's a little red mark on there, but all you do is insert this little stud into that loop. And I'll show you a close-up of that as well. But that's what you have. You have essentially a long triangle. So your foot end is like a standard gathered end hammock. Your head end is the wide spreader bar, and that provides you with the flat lay or your ability to roll to your side. Now this is probably a little too far apart. Try and lower it down just a bit. This is also a really, really, really flexible. You've got very light fabric, so you're going to get a lot of stretch. So you can see, I'm 6 feet tall. This is above my waist. Now we'll see how much it sags. That's about the position that I would like to lay in right there. I'm a side sleeper, so I can roll over on my side.
even though it was way above my waist when it was unoccupied, it's right at the right height now for getting in and out.
This is the new Onewind Bridge Hammock. This is their version. As you can see, it uses two suspension lines at one end and then one line at the foot end. It has a single spreader pole, and it's the most simple possible arrangement. There are no sleeves that it goes in. All it does is just wrap around the suspension line, and that's the spreader bar is attached just strictly by friction under tension there. Now I'm using the Eno Helio suspension, and with the Eno hammocks they come with a little toggle. In this case I just picked up a stick off the ground and that became my toggle, which obviously would also serve as a water break from water running down the lines. So it comes down from the suspension, spreads out with the spreader bar, and that would be your head end. Obviously it does have a small sack for your miscellaneous gear, and then your foot end would be the same as a gathered end hammock, except the spreader bar allows you to lay flat or slightly to one side. So on this end it also goes back up to the Helio suspension, which is adjustable without any knots, of course, and then I've got a toggle on there. So now I'll show you the suspension that actually comes with the Onewind hammock. So here's the Eno Helio strap, and then above it is the Onewind strap coming down the suspension to the hammock. The hammock is laying on the ground and up to the same exact tree on the other side. So with the Helios suspension, I had this hammock suspended above my waist. These lines are as short as I can make them, and I'm way, way, way farther apart. I could probably go from that tree another 10 feet or more to one of these other trees and still have plenty of line left. So potentially you could shorten these lines or this main line here. It's the same idea as the Helios strap. It gives you a little bead to hold on to here to adjust, and then a rope to pull to loosen. The line thickness is a little bit greater than the Helios, so it should be at least as strong. The Helios is rated at 300 pounds on each end, so I would guess these are rated for about the same. There were no instructions. It did include some carabiners. The only way I could figure out how to use it was to use a carabiner on the strap end so that there's a pulley type arrangement, and then I used the loop at the hammock end, or you could use a toggle or another carabiner. But one way or another, either you have to use poles or trees that are at least 25-30 feet apart, or you're gonna have to shorten these ropes to match your hammock. So I think this is a great hammock for the money. Obviously this model does not include the bug net. You would need to supply your own net. I think it would work really well with underquilt. The gathered end is no problem, that'll attach, and then the upper end you could spread apart and attach to the spreader poles there.